This is like the end of the team?
Technically, we were never really a team.
Oh, we were a team.
I'll see you all again sometime.
I quit.
Oh, I've missed you, Boy Wonder.
You mind if I hang at your place a while?
Stay as long as you need. As long as you still got game.
Fuck me.
This alphabet has been lost for centuries.
Can you translate that?
It's definitely a mission statement for your friend who's referred to as Starfire. Her mission is to secure the Raven.
Bruce,
wait.
Robin was the answer. Robin was gonna fix everything. But you ruined it! You blame Zuko? You blame Bruce? No. No, it was you! You made him into a monster!
It all has to end.
You gonna watch till the bitter end, or are you ready to get out of here?
Hey everybody, it's Charlie. We finally have Donna Troy, Wonder Girl, on Titans. So we got to talk about the Wonder Woman of it all inside this universe and the origin of Nightwing. The scene where you watch him confront himself psychologically and then watch his Robin costume get blown up is the beginning of Nightwing, destroying the past so that you can move forward with a little bit of help from a Wonder Woman character. So there's a new round of that DC streaming service giveaway. All you have to do to enter is be a subscriber and leave a Titans-related comment on the video. Let's start with the Donna Troy stuff first, then I'll talk about the origin of Nightwing, because I definitely do think that he's going to get that Nightwing costume in the finale. But Donna Troy, if you haven't read her in the comics or you're not familiar with her, she's been a member of the team since they debuted in the 1960s. What happened is the first time the Teen Titans name was ever used was when Kid Flash, Aqualad, and Robin, Dick Grayson, teamed up in Brave and the Bold number 60 in July 1965. A couple months after that, in December, they added Donna Troy to the team, and at the time, she was called Wonder Woman's younger sister. So this is the mid-1960s. During the next 50 years of comics, they changed her backstory so many times that it became an ongoing meta story within the Teen Titans comics. They even did a Who is Donna Troy issue, where it's like, my backstory doesn't make sense, what's going on? And as of DC Rebirth, right now, her current origin story is that she was created from a lump of clay by a sorceress to destroy Wonder Woman. The Amazonians rescued her and gave her false memories to make her think that she had a long-running history with Wonder Woman so that she'd have a more livable, pleasant life. So she's like this weapon of mass destruction that was created with the powers of Wonder Woman. So a big part of her story is finding her own identity. And they're kind of doing that on Titans right now. Like Robin just left behind the Robin identity. He burned his costume and now he's looking for a new identity, aka Nightwing. So if it wasn't clear, in the Titans universe, they have history. Robin has chemistry with most of the women that he comes into contact with. So in the Hawk and Dove episode, they have the flashback where he was in a relationship briefly with Dove. He also has romantic history with Donna Troy. No surprise there, he's one of the most eligible bachelors in the DC Comics universe. All the ladies want a piece of him. I don't know if they're going to do any kind of love triangle situation or anything like that, but I do believe that Donna Troy is going to be a bigger character on the team during Season 2, and they've already been renewed for Season 2. But within the context of this trailer, she's just helping him identify Starfire. This is who she is. Her name is Starfire. This is why she came. She's looking for the Raven, talking about the prophecy that she's going to bring Trigon to this universe. one of the reasons why Starfire would care about that is because even though she's from a different planet in a different part of the universe, Trigon is like the Dormammu of the DC comic book universe. He's the evil ruler of multiple dimensions. So he enters a new dimension, takes it over because he's so powerful, and then moves on to the next one. The laws of magic that bind him are such that he can only enter other universes through one of his natural-born children. So Raven, being his daughter, is his conduit to our reality, and that's what they're trying to stop. They haven't said if Titan's Donna Troy is as old as comic book Donna Troy, because she would be ancient. That's why she says this is a dead language. It's just a reference to her being around for so long. So that's why Dick Grayson is like, can you translate this? Because you were around when people originally spoke it. So it's just the beginning of her with the team. I don't know how many episodes she's going to be in this season, but like I said, I think she'll be a much bigger thing next season. I think they spent most of season one trying to find out what works best, which characters fit with the team best. Like, they have Cyborg debuting during Doom Patrol. It's a pretty foregone conclusion that eventually he'll come on to Titans and cross over with them because he's a core Teen Titans character in the comics. But getting to the Nightwing of it all, so that whole scene with him being tortured psychologically to try and confront his own demons and the idea that he needs to adopt a new identity, was this them pushing him on the path to Nightwing? Thankfully, they had that moment where you see his broken costume with the R melting out of the chest. So it's like saying that Robin is no more. I'm not this person. That's why in the trailer, he makes it seem like they're breaking up. Well, we were never really a team. The whole idea being that he'll get his shit together in the next couple of episodes, they'll reform the Titans by the finale, and he'll adopt the Nightwing identity, probably with a little gift from Bruce Wayne in the form of a Nightwing costume. Extra strong Xylon fibers, just like Jason Todd was telling him, the new Robin costume is so sick, bro, the old one, you have to admit, it's kind of outdated. He was shading Dick Grayson for the old technology in the original Robin costume. Like, the new one is just so much better. Just letting you know that it's time for him to get a new costume. So far, I haven't seen any leaks or anything like that of what it's going to look like. Right now, the finale is scheduled for December 21st. And don't forget that Young Justice Season 3 is premiering January 4th. So they go on break the week of Christmas, then everything comes back and it's Young Justice for 13 episodes. There will be more trailers for that. Here's just a brief clip if you haven't seen any of the previous Young Justice videos that I've done. Cannot wait for Young Justice. What'll happen is I'll talk about that stuff when they start dropping new footage for it, so no worries, just a couple more weeks to go. We'll also be having all the DC TV, Flash, Arrow, Elseworlds crossover episodes in the next couple of weeks too, with the Flash 100th episode. So there is a lot of really big comic book stuff happening in December between Marvel and DC. Whole bunch of big trailers coming from all over the place. As long as you have alerts enabled for my channel, you guys should get all the videos, so no worries. Click here for my non-spoilery Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse early review, and click here for that brand new Lion King trailer. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.